ሰላምታ ጤና ይስጥልኝ። This is kind of weird, but all right. This is supposed to be a demonstrative presentation, and we're having difficulties with the sound. Let us pray that this works. Okay, Christian persecution. So we got informed it's taking place. There is a substantial amount of evidence that in fact this is happening. And so we as elect Rastafari must maintain our integrity and speak out for them. You know, we must be father to the fatherless, to the orphans, you know, husbandmen to the widows, and you know, to put this in a context, you know, in a fuller context, you know, closer to its fullness. We speak of the thousands of different Christian divisions of the whole truth, right? Regardless the differences that may exist between I and I, we must remember and recall, bring to our memory that it's not been given to them in its fullness. That is where we come in, right? So if they don't know, we're not doing our job. That's basically what it comes down to. So we must, putting this word of truth in a more full context would be, we must be the light and the head, the direction, the exemplary life to those churches that do not have a husbandman. They are widows. They don't have a father. You know, they speak of a celestial father. They speak of a heavenly father and stuff like that, but they don't have a earthly father in his imperial majesty as we do. And so we must be fathers in a sense, in a true sense, in a full sense, to those children without it within these congregations that cannot partake in the truth of our Majesty Most High, you know, Jah Rastafari, and so also to those women that, even though some of them within these congregations may be married, you know, still it's not been given to those men to have their ras, their head in the right place, right? So we must speak out, and we must, you know, we just got to do that which we got to do. And so that is what we're gonna do here. But first, being that we already we planned on it, right? But since we brought that forth first, we have to include some scripture, and it reads here. This is the general epistle of James, Ya'ikob, and so it is chapter 1, and it's verse 26. Old Schofield Reference Study Bible, or Study Bible, gives us a title to these verses, and it reads, "The Test of True Religion. If any man among you seem to be religious and bridleth not his tongue, but deceiveth his own heart, this man's religion is in vain." You know, to be 100% honest, we didn't even study this, and we don't know exactly what that even means, but we do know that the only way that we could you know, prove to the fullness that what we are is what is, it's our walk. We must live emulate that exemplary life of Yeshua HaMashiach to the fullness of our ability, and then the fulfillment of a faithful life in that walk would be the most concrete evidence. And so we just have to put that forth, because then our religion would be in vain. If our lives do not add up to that which we accept to be true, then it is in vain. You know, we have to illuminate people by the way that we walk and stuff like that. And so, like, if we are that example, then there is no way to disprove our truth, even though we know it's true. But a lot of people would deceive themselves in pretending it's not. And so when we live perfect lives, then you can't disprove that. You know, it's more concrete than even scientific any scientific evidence, so called, and stuff like that. So the life we live is the truth, you know. Okay, this just came to mind. It's like Jesus Christos, you know, the Messiah, the Mashiach, the Messiah, the anointed. He more than anything else, he showed us and shows us and always will show us that the differences of theosophies and theologies and the divinities and stuff like that. That's stuff that really doesn't even matter when we're speaking of practicality and putting our faith and thus proving our religion. That doesn't even make any difference. So we find ourselves in a position where every human individual is fighting for ideas and concepts that are way beyond that which even matters, in the human life at least. And so Yeshua, he teaches us clearly that it is in his behavior that you can settle these differences in mind, because it is the practicality of his way of life that proves without a doubt that what he says is in fact. And so, you know, that's extremely important to understand. It's like we may not be able to measure our like ideas and beliefs and faith in the highest you know, receptivity or you know, those truths that cannot be proved in fullness, you know, via this language, via this pilgrimage, this experience as a human within the human community. But for sure we can demonstrate the walk, and if that walk is perfect and flawless and stuff like that, then without a doubt, then the faith is concrete. It's rooted, it's founded and grounded in truth and nothing but truth. Also, integrity. We must keep our integrity. You know, this is completely not what we were intending to speak on, but nonetheless, you know, we shall. How could we say the spirit, right? Yeshua gives us an example, like I think it's John chapter 3 actually, where he's speaking with Nicodemus, and they get into this conversation, and you know, Yeshua HaMashiach, he makes mention of this, the being reborn, and he says something like you can hear the wind and stuff like that, and you can feel it, but you don't even know where it's coming from or where it goes. And so he likens that to the Holy Spirit, right? Let's find that real quick. The indwelling spirit, and okay, actually no, my bad, that's completely not the scripture. Okay, so yes was answered and said to him, this is on the Gospel of St. John chapter 3, verse 10. Yes was answered and said to him, art thou a master of Israel, and thou knowest not these things? Verily, verily, I say to thee, we speak that we do know, and testify that we have seen, and ye receive not our witness. If I have told you earthly things, and ye believe not, how shall ye believe if I tell you of heavenly things? So this kind of goes, this is perfect, actually. And we give thanks to the Most High God, Jah Rastafari, you know, even His Imperial Majesty, and yes, His Good Source, because that's exactly what we said. You know, if we can't even communicate the earthly things to individuals, how how much less possible will it be for I and I to receive like divine truths or vibrations and stuff like that. And so basically we must walk the walk. And so continuing, it says actually I think we skipped the verse. We speak that we do know, and we testify that we have seen. Well, you know, nonetheless, and we receive, and ye receive not our witness. If I have told you earthly things, and ye yet believe not, how shall ye believe if I tell you the heavenly things? And no man hath ascended up to heaven, but he that came down from heaven, even the Son of Man which is in heaven. And as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, even must the Son of Man be lifted, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have eternal life. For God so loved the world. And we're beginning to understand that this isn't even the scripture that we were looking for. It's actually like right above that. So my bad for that. It's let's go to verse 5. It says, yes was answered. Verse 5, verily, verily, in it, I say to thee, except a man be born of water and of spirit, he cannot enter into the kingdom of God. That which is born of the flesh is flesh. That which is born of the spirit is spirit. Marvel not that I said to thee, ye must be born again. The wind bloweth where it listeth, and thou hearest the sound thereof, but thou cannot tell whence it cometh and whither it goeth. Right? So is everyone that is born of the Spirit. So, okay, excuse me for actually not getting that right the first time, but makes no difference. It's right now. So let us go on forth. The whole blowing and the wind and the air, is kind of, we're gonna try to use that to kind of direct a higher thought, we would say, in what is taking place. The expressed image, the word, okay? Turns out that there is no such thing as nothing. Sorry, everything that is apparently nothing is actually, it actually has more life than what we think is life, like this and stuff like that. So, okay, one way that we could prove to the fullness that there is life in the air, and this is, Jesus is the Christ. He's using the wind, the air. He's likening it. He is making a likening of that to spirit, right? So, what spirit are we? Okay, so the air is so perfect and so full of life that when you transmit frequencies, vibrations through the airwaves, whether it be radio waves, television waves or whatever those kind of waves are called, whether it be light rays waves. Light waves or light rays, any kind of frequency vibration that travels across the air, it's actually upholded and uplifted and transported in a perfection in which it doesn't matter how many thousands of different channels are in the air, they don't get mixed up, and so they send off a signal, a transmission, a frequency, a vibration. They travel across the airwaves. The air highway, the higher ways, the highway, the king's highway, the Magus's highway, and so like, none of them, even though they're crossing each other and stuff like that, the air is so full of life and perfected to the fullness that they don't get mixed up. At the ending reception, at the wherever that transmission is received, it is it actually whatever antenna, whatever. Gadgets are used to receive that signal. They transmit it to the fullness, So if it's a radio show, whatever was vocalized in the station, it becomes transported, transmitted, and received, and thus displayed, or the sound becomes hearable. And so that's exactly kind of like the true faith, It's like Jaja gives off a certain vibration, a frequency. One must be able to. It'll travel along its path without being interrupted, without coming across any obstacle or corruption. It'll receive that which is of that truth, and that receiving station will make manifest that which it has been received. The word basically is what we're trying to say. So like the word, made flesh, because we are to live it, we are to walk it, we are to be it, and be that expressed image, like we gotta get our programming down and stuff like that. We gotta, in this how does His Majesty said, like in this world that has become like a theater, a comedy, my part is in I glory in the Bible and stuff like that. And so we actually forgot why we even brought that forth. So let us just continue with what we actually wanted to make mention. So now, because of this persecuting, okay, that's kind of weird. We might cut this off, because that we can't recall why we said all that. So nonetheless, so what we wanted to put forth was a call to arms, and because we thought it'd be a great idea to have kind of like a Rastafari martial arts center, stuff like that, where ones that are skilled in certain talents or certain martial arts or certain defensive tactics or self-defense, that we could put this forth, in the airwaves and make manifest that which we have already been predestinated to have learned, and then show it and teach it to those individuals that might actually have some use for it, and forget not that we are in a continual warfare. It doesn't mean, even though this is a spiritual warfare, it don't mean that the body don't need no discipline, so originally we wanted to put out the message to have like some of the brothers or sisters that have been taught or learned in the defensive department to put out like some training, some lessons, you know, for whatever reason. Some people may not have money or the time to enlist into a karate or something like that, but they might have a few minutes to check out a homie's video and then learn from him. And in many ways, it'll probably be best because, you know, when people get a degree or a diploma or a black belt, you get caught up in the concept and you forget the truth, you know. So it's actually, we would actually encourage ones that are self-taught to go forth and put this out in the airwaves, that we all may benefit from the knowledge of you and be, you know, distribute our wealth, you know, what's been given to us, and share with those in need. In this case, those in Northern Africa and those areas known as the Middle East that are, you know, oftentimes in conflict. A lot of our Christian brothers and sisters need to have some of these defensive tactics, you know. If they're taking advantage of the Christians in those areas and doing what they're doing to them, is because they don't have a man. You know, they don't have a father. Their churches does not have a man. You know, like, we have our father. We must be a father to those people, because they don't have a man to stand up and fight for them. So we got to do that. And, you know, if anyone's got any better ideas, you know, put them out. So we thought it would be, you know, some classes and stuff like that where ones could incorporate some of their learned skills and put them out, so that these individuals could at least, you know, go if they're going to go out, you know, it's not a bad thing. It's a crown of martyrdom. It's like a free pass to that which we all should be striving for and hoping for and praying for. so like, but at least that they put a fight, you know, and stuff like that, so that these other individuals, and we're not prepared to call them Muslims, because in Ethiopia existed a people that we would declare to be Muslim, and they kept the peace with the Ethiopian Christians. So these people are anti-Christian. They're not Muslims, and it's not fair to call some psycho anti-Christian individuals doing all the devilish and heathen work that they're doing. It's not fair to call them Muslims amongst those that are true and faithful to at least that faith that has been taught to them. And so, but then again, some of these Muslims that are true in spirit and faith must ally themselves with truth. In this case, Rastafari, the only truth, that they may be known, and they too must speak out against these other people that we're not prepared to name as oftentimes they are named, you know, even though they add like a Muslim extremist. No. If you're Muslim, then you don't deal with no killing and no violence and stuff like that. That's clear, you know. Ethiopia is a testimony to that, you know. So, but nonetheless, going forward, all right, so the school of like martial arts, Rastafari, but then we thought, even though it's a great idea, anyone could just, you know, ask anyone else to put in the work. But it takes an exemplary character like His Majesty, which directed on thyself to Yeshua HaMashiach. And so, rather than just ask anyone to do something, it's best that one set the example. So it's what we attempt to do. So we're gonna actually present an exemplary like exercise and stuff like that, because we're not well learned in like the defensive and stuff like that, or maybe we are, but you know, that'll come, you know, if it comes. So nonetheless, it's an exercise, but there's a specific reason why we're gonna actually show that. But back to the whole defense, His Majesty did not carry a sword in vain, you know. If ones recall, when he went up into it, he didn't go to the Vatican, right? He went to some of this, to another place. We can't recall, forgive us for it, but he had his sword in on his side, right? And that wasn't there for show, you know what I'm saying? He knew how to use it. It's a fact. Even though His Majesty is a man that forms events, shapes events rather than waits for them to happen. So basically what that means, he's already victorious, he's already prevailed, like he's like a million steps ahead of the enemy. And so the enemy has already been defeated by the time that the confrontation takes place. And so in most cases, His Majesty was like already triumphant. So but he still carried the sword because you know, it's a continual warfare, you know. But he was aware of that, and so he, being a trained man of war, never just overlooked the practicality of things and how one must always be prepared. Even in this one video, and I think it's the video in Amharic, where there's a testimony where someone walks in into His Majesty's bedroom or chambers, and they see him doing exercises that a man of that age would not be capable of doing. And so what it is, they don't go into details. We forgot what that video is called, but it's like a full documentary that they put together in Amharic. And so, but anyways, what we're trying to say is that we must be prepared. So just trying to bring forth some evidence and to support and sustain our idea of being prepared in mind and in body. Like, we must keep that balance. We can't we can't just think that being prepared in the spiritual will be enough. You know, if there's a situation where you got to run and you're not in condition to run, it don't matter how advanced in the spiritual you are, you're gonna get caught. You're gonna get caught up, you know, with your foolishness. And there must be a balance that has to do with why we brought forth the whole transmission and receiving of the frequency, the waves, the vibrations of His Majesty, but it's still not coming to us, so we're just going to continue. Now, this exercise, okay, we are just going to, when you're incarcerated, you're expected to keep fit, and you're expected to be on guard all the time, because it is a continual warfare. If there means that the individual put in some work, then you got to put in the work. And let us remind all and I that we are in a, even though some of us have been freed, and truly, if freed by the Son, then free indeed, we are in a world that is incarcerated. The minds of people have been limited, have been chained, and cannot transgress the program. So we got to break that program. And so this is a constant warfare, for like the same old joke, you know, don't forget that. So basically, we're just going to give like an example, and then we're going to give some explanation as to why it is effective. And then we're going to make that connection to truth, meditation, and okay, we actually got it. My bad, we're running out of battery, but still. Okay, and then we're going to make that connection between meditation and the truth in prayer, and how it is in balanced with its fullness. This is actually pretty cool. Now, it's, at first it was intimidating, but now it's on. Oh, now it's on. Okay, one second. Okay, so basically that was an example, right? But you have to do that continually. It's a process. And so you have to do that. That would be like, we just did two right there. So that whole series of exercises would be two. When you're barely locked up, you have to do 113, just aside from your daily exercise, because the Hispanics are broken up just like Blacks, and so you have your Bloods and your Crips. In this case, we would be like the Crips, and that would be like the South Side, and you're constantly at war, so you got to keep fit. And what this will do, this is a perfect exercise, because you don't need anything. All you need is creativity and patience and the will to do it. They're called burpees, right? But watch, it'll help out your reach. If you're engaging in conflict, you'll find this, the whole stretching out, you'll find it to be quite useful, because you know, try it and you will come to realize that it's not easy to reach that part of your back, right? And so that'll allow some, like, some, you know, some of that. And and then the actual impact is strengthening. It's endurance, and then you work your abs, right? It'll apply pressure and vibration to your abs. It'll strengthen them, and then your cherry pickers, they would say, and then your squats, which will work out your legs. Instead, the squats are probably what tires people the most, because we work less on the foundation, which is where we should be strengthened even more, because if your legs collapse, your upper body is gone. It's like if people are familiar with some of those fighting, whatever they call them, these latter day Roman kind of like Coliseum fights, like UFC and stuff like that. If you see sometimes when people get knocked out, it's their legs that give out. It's as weird as that may sound. It's not their upper body. It's their legs. Their legs give out. They're weak. They're tired. Sometimes it's not even the punch. Sometimes it's that they can't stand anymore. And so foundation is the key. And so the squats really, really get the foundation going. And then you have all kinds of things. I mean, you have triceps. You work out your biceps. You work out. It's conditioning, because it's continual, and it'll work on your it'll help you to maintain rhythm. It'll help your balance, because you have to maintain balance, your abs, your thighs, your legs, your triceps, your biceps. Creativity, because you can include any kind of exercise within that. There's people that take this to the fullness, and it'll take you like 10 minutes to do one rep, because they throw in all kinds of different variables within the exercise. And then the stamina, you'll be able to maintain. But the reason we included this, it gives us an opportunity to make a connection of the truth. This is where meditation comes in, and prayer, and how prayer is not just whatever. There's a reason for it. And so if we know the truth comes from Ethiopia, then we can use Ethiopia as an example, and our example will prove itself to be that which is and nothing else. Okay, so a lot of people think that, watch, we'll just do it. We've seen this in Ethiopian prayer. So something to the effect of, like, and so we probably did that wrong, but still. And so they do that over and over and over and over. And when we saw that, we were like, that's like doing burpees, but and it is, but without the push-ups and stuff like that. But what led us to that idea was that we saw elder women that were probably like 80, 90, and 70, and 60, even 50, doing that over and over. And of course, some did it to a higher degree, and some did it less, and there were some really old ladies that didn't didn't do the whole, like, but they would at least go down, like, as far down as possible. And that really, like, it connected in our brain, because when you're exercising, it relaxes, like, the mind, really. It leaves you in a state in which you can, the body is on autopilot, and then, but it clears everything, because you're kind of like, you're being tired, and you're just you're not thinking in no BS, basically. And it's a meditation where one can come to understand things and learn, and just in a stress-free environment, even though you're under a lot of physical activity, we could say. But what we're trying to say here is that we liken that to the exercise that we presented earlier, because nothing that is of truth is worthless, is just out of pure tradition. Now, a lot of Ethiopians may not be able to explain this, because it's been handed to them as pure tradition and customs, but there is truth to everything. Why else would this be expected? Just because someone thought, oh, you know what, it would be fun to include this kind of prayer and activity. I do the whole, the crossing of the arms, that's always represented in, well, it's the cross, basically. The pounding of the chest, we liken that to Adam. every time he, we forgot, but every time something happened, he would pound his chest. And we liken that to that. And the whole face to upon the ground, it's every time one would humble themselves to the Most High, and we're in the presence of the Most High, you get what is, everyone always, they fall down face flat upon the ground, right? And then they have to stand up. And so basically, it creates this rhythmic process of meditation, communication with the Most High. And when it's continual, a peaceful state of mind and a fullness, you know, the body under stress, under pain, you could say, and then a full connection with the Most High, with the higher mind. And you got to remember that some of these ladies are like 100 years old and true. And so, like, they're doing this. That means that they have to be, like, physically fit in some amount of level to be able to even obtain this kind of prayer. And so, regardless what ones want to pretend, there were some old ladies doing some exercise that I know 20-year-olds cannot do. And so, you know, put everything in its fullness. We accept this to be, like, the fullness of that ritual. Even if it's not well understood, even if we didn't do a great job of presenting it. But in America, there are people that are 30 years old, 25 years old, 5 years old, 10 years old, that cannot perform these exercises. So within the true, well, we don't want to say true, because of the whole corruption within the Ethiopian Orthodox, quote-unquote, church, but at one point in time, there was truth within it. And so if ones want to argue what they want to argue, you can't argue with the fact that these elder beings are performing some kind of exercise that is beneficial to their health. And thus, that type of prayer, it cannot just be discarded as purely traditional or cultural or just customary. And so that's basically... That's basically what we wanted to make mention. Oh, and one last important note. If ones do actually, like, you know, bring forth some Rastafari training, self-defense classes, link it to Iandike, because we know that there's been a lot of true brothers and sisters in spirit and you know, in faith and in spirit and truth have been, you know, posting teachings and communicating and stuff like that, but we gotta have, like, order. And so we ask that ones either, if you know of any channels on the tubes or on any kinds of on any internet trans communications and stuff like that, to link the information to our channel or to some of the Facebook pages or to Rastafari Foundation. It don't matter, just put the information out there, because we've come across some individuals, brothers and sisters, that have been putting out some material, and we had no idea. And it's not that we don't want to support the family, is that sometimes the family don't know what the family's doing, and so we got to maintain that order. And so we give thanks to the Most High God, Jah, Rastafari, and the Yehoshua HaMashiach, and we hope that this presentation has been in some way of some use. Skip that. Shalom, you have to.